The Institute works 365 days a year to improve the lives of people in Wisconsin by discussion of issues forward that improve the quality of life. We are discussing and researching and educating the public on issues that are important to every man and woman and child in this state.
Well, the Badger Institute's had a major impact on public policy here in the state of Wisconsin, certainly for me personally, but I know for lawmakers, others involved in policy at the state and at the local level. Good example, years ago we made a change in Act 10 that made all sorts of improvements, but one of the big ones was it allowed school districts to bid out their health insurance, saving millions of dollars. Well, that idea came from a paper, really, that years ago the Badger Institute, in its former name, had put together and provided to me and to others.
Well, the Badger Institute has had a tremendous impact on the state. It's tackled many important issues, whether it's prevailing wage, whether it's the tolling issue, whether it's recidivism in prisons and the costs of incarceration, whether it's early childhood development issues. The Institute has really been a place where policymakers, average citizens, business leaders can go to for quality analysis.
The Badger Institute has done extraordinary work when it comes to prison reentry policy and anti-poverty policy, big ideas with principled conservative roots. And what's amazing is the Badger Institute has made that its life's work.
I appreciate the Badger Institute for helping to open up the eyes of people who hadn't thought about correction reform. It really has been a resource. I was excited to be able to see them doing sessions to bring people in so that law enforcement and legislators and judges and district attorneys, prosecutors would be able to see different perspectives.
One of the best things about the Badger Institute is that they have always been ahead of their time. If you go back and look at the history of things like school choice, right to work, Act 10 reforms, licensing reforms, tolling, they have been ahead of the curve almost every single time, and the Wisconsin legislature has usually been wise enough to follow their lead.
The Badger Institute has been at times a lone voice over the years on free markets, on personal responsibility, on limited government, and it's very important. Look at school choice, for instance. The Badger Institute has been there for years on this topic. We're just now starting to see the fruits of the impact of school choice.
For 30 years, the Badger Institute has worked tirelessly to make sure that everyone in Wisconsin is free to pursue their American dream.
If you are a true believer in free markets and you understand how important competition is, another area that's always been an issue was repealing the minimum markup law, and the Badger Institute has written lots on this issue, and I have used it time and time again.
Well, there's no question that WPRI has had a huge impact. I know that Tommy Thompson really paid attention to the studies we did and the recommendations we had, and it's reflected in what is the law of the state now.
The Institute can help the lives of folks within our state by helping define public policies that drive long-term economic prosperity within the state. Taxes in the state of Wisconsin need to be competitive. Forget about the political rhetoric. Think about what we need to do to attract capital to the state of Wisconsin.
We're so proud of what Wisconsin Interest has done and been over the years, a policy journal and really a mainstream magazine. But this is a new era. We need policy research that really digs deep. We need to tell stories about people who understand the value of free markets and individual aspiration. And so we're changing our name. We're changing the name of the magazine to Diggings.
I really love getting my magazine, Diggings, from the Badger Institute, because this is one of those policy periodicals that you can actually sit down and relax with and dig deep into policy. That's a good time for someone who likes to solve challenges.
We're incredibly excited about the future, both in Wisconsin and here at the Badger Institute. We're going to continue with our work in areas like federal grants, on corrections, on onerous government regulations in the professional licensing area. But we'll also be embarking on some new initiatives, probably the biggest one on taxation. We're an overtaxed state. We need a new tax mix in order to create really a growth environment for our communities, for our people, where everybody can prosper. We're starting a visiting fellows program where we can tap into the best minds in America on important economic issues. We're so proud of what we've accomplished, but we know we couldn't have done it without so much help from our supporters, from donors, from like-minded legislators who've enacted our policies, from people all over the state of Wisconsin. We do what we do because it helps people throughout Wisconsin achieve their dreams. We believe in the importance of ideas. It's ideas that drive America forward. Free markets, opportunity, prosperity, none of them can exist without the other two. We're the Badger Institute.